This is the story of the monkey and the crocodile. You can read along with Karadi, the bear. You will know it is time to turn the page when you hear his cane tap like this. Let us begin now.
Beside a river which flows through the dark forests of central India, stands an old, majestic rose apple tree. Juicy red and pink apples cling to the branches, while the blowing wind sheds a few to the ground. From the top of this tree, I, Karadi the bear, hear monkeys chattering. I can see naughty pink face swinging from branch to branch, teasing the other monkeys while eating apples. He reminds me of his father, Red Face, who in his young days was just as naughty as him. I'm reminded of the time when Red Face outsmarted a crocodile that lurked in these river waters. Would you like to hear about that? In those days, many hungry crocodiles used to swim in the river. Red Face was always full of pranks. He would sometimes climb to the top branches of the tree and throw some ripe apples at the hungry crocodiles, trying to annoy them. Now, we all know that crocodiles do not eat fruit, don't we? But one day, Red Face threw an apple at a crocodile who, as always, was sleeping with his mouth open. The apple landed in the crocodile's mouth. Aroused, he crunched the apple and loved the taste of it.
"Hurrah!"
thought Jagged Jaws, for that was the crocodile's name. His jaws were huge and ugly. When opened, they revealed two rows of sharp, pointed teeth.
"If the monkey with the red face became my friend,"
thought Jagged Jaws,
"I would never have to be hungry again. Whenever I am too lazy to hunt for food, he can feed me the rose apples."
So, Jagged Jaws swam up to the tree and began to cry. Huge crocodile tears fell from his eyes. Red Face, listening to his wails, said,
"Stop! Stop that, you beastly crocodile! Why do you cry near my rose apple tree?"
Oh, my dear friend, please do not be unkind. For days I have not eaten a morsel of food. My stomach growls, my head spins, and I fear that I am going to die. Would you, out of the kindness of your heart, throw me a few rose apples and save me from death?"
Saying this, Jagged Jaws once again wept more crocodile tears.
"Hush, hush!"
Red silenced Jagged Jaws.
"Wipe those tears. If you come by my tree every day at noon and call out my name, I will throw you some rose apples. By the way, my name is Red Face."
"I shall be your friend forever. Never will I forget this kindness. Thank you. Thank you so much."
From that day on, Jagged Jaws would swim to the tree at noon. Red Face, true to his word, would throw down a few apples. The crocodile would eat the fruit and sit for a long time.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.